So, welcome to the Quint.
Thank you, thank you. It's been such a long time.
So, how is self-isolation going?
No, it's not going that great. But yeah, I mean, I'm accused of being an eternal optimist. I always try to see the absolute positive side of it. And by the looks of it, I have never attended third grade. So along with my son, I'm learning all the things that I missed out when I was in third grade. So feel absolutely like, did I learn all this? Or like what's happening? Like how are the kids nowadays managing this?
Yes, and talking about third grade, what grade were you in when you did Malgudi days?
I was in fifth grade, I think. Yeah, no, fourth grade, fourth or fifth, around that time of. I just completed 10. I had just stepped into 11. So around fourth or fifth.
And you must be the boy in school, the blue-eyed boy in school.
No, nothing like that. So these are all pre-Facebook, pre-social media, pre-television days, as in of multitude channels. So at best, if your name came up in a newspaper, it was widely appreciated. And of course, the cinema, I mean, the Malgudi days was actually shot as a movie, Swami and His Friends, and then later edited into a series. I'm not sure many people know this. So it was shot simultaneously in Hindi and English. And it was literally like I think maybe the producer got cold feet, so we shot some more and edited it into a series. So television itself was completely new for us. So being in cinema was wow. I mean, you get to go to theater, so very few people would see it. So I was not blue-eyed in any sense. Only thing, they would be a little bit sympathetic towards me because I would miss a lot of classes, and then everybody would pitch in to help me out, saying, okay, catch this up. But big challenge there was I didn't know a word of Hindi or English. So I had to literally learn that language, then understand, translate in my brain into Kannada, understand what it is, and then figure out the commas and full stops, and then go through it twice.
That's too much for a child, no?
No, see, you have to understand, my first movie was when I was 3. So cinema was normal to me. The other normal stuff was all weird for me.
We are right now in our houses and Didi is rerunning Mahabharata, Ramayana, and yeah, we have a list of shows that we really want to see. And Malgudi days is in the top.
So, my God.
Other shows that you would want to watch?
Ye Jo Hai Zindagi, Nukkad, Thomas, yes. My God, what a serial. I was like, you know, mind-blowing. And this list goes on and on. Like, I'll be doing injustice if I leave out other names. But then, yeah, those were different days, and episodes would end on the same day. You would get to some result on the same day. I'm not being critical of the present day soap operas, but had a moral, it had the message, and it was, I mean, it is a completely different era altogether. So, yeah, but I'm really surprised that kids are able to even remotely relate to Swami. That's surprising to me with this modern day gadgetry and distractions. And it's a very, very pleasant surprise that, you know, people are able to relate to Swami in any manner.
Tell me one thing. How did your son react when he saw Swami? Swami and Friends or Malgudi days. Do you remember what the first time you made him see it?
Yeah, so his was very, very normal. I mean, it was like almost like an anticlimax. He's like, yeah, oh, that's you. Okay, this looks good. And that's it. I'm like, oh, that's it. Then I understood, see, for them, that's the normal, right? They have access to iPads. They have access to enormous content of cartoons and normal stuff, and the access to information is so huge for them. The outlook is far, far bigger, and the information available is huge. So therefore, I think he was like, okay, he acts, okay, fine. I mean, so what am I supposed to do? Like, so I don't think he's there yet for me to kind of force him to sit and watch the show with me. I hope he'll get there.
You loved camera and you've been an actor since 3 years old. Why did you leave acting?
See, I did, my career spanned almost 15 years, 15 to 16 years. And I assure you, people who are in the creative industry over that period of time, there is some amount of, you get to a point where you either enjoy it or you're trying to raise the bar even higher and even higher. And then the opportunities aren't there anymore. And I was really, really, really lucky. And I emphasize this no extent. I'm not sure on the quality of my acting, but then I had some wonderful directors, wonderful scripts. So it's just that I reached a point where I'm like, oh God, I've done 68 movies, you know, international awards, national president's awards, state's awards, now what? So I was getting to the point where I was getting like a little bit, it was becoming monotonous. It was becoming very normal. And I said, look, it's not giving me, I'm not having fun anymore. And for me, what others would call normal was what I was yearning for. Like, get up on a Sunday and not worried about the first shot, whether the light is out or not. Just sleep.
Wow.
Go to a pani puri, masal puri shop and not be either pink-cheeked or, you know, somebody, you know, asking me the same question. You know, tell a dialogue. Like, I don't know what they mean when they ask me this. Okay, tell a dialogue. I mean, it's not like a stock of things that we have. Like, just say a dialogue, right? Or act. That's even worse. Tell a dialogue is at least makes sense. Like,
act karke dikhao.
Like, what do you mean? Like, what do you expect me to do, right? So those normalcies I yearned for. So, and I said, let me quickly quit, take a break, you know, finish my education. This I can emphasize up to no end. So once I finished that, I thought, okay, I'll come back and figure it out. But it didn't work that way. As with everybody in Bangalore, I got into software, and then the bust happened. Then I was like, oh God, I should do something. So I was part of the team. Like, I came up with the first ever time we put up SSLC, PUC, that is matriculation, pre-university results ever online. Diploma, engineering results in this one. This is way back in 99, 2000. Then I went on to work with the governmental agency for the Bhoomi, the digitization of land records, and so on and so forth. So this journey from there has been wonderful. There is still hope for me to come back, or at least to direct.
Thank you so much. Thank you for talking to us. Thank you. Bye. Have fun.
Bye. Thank you all of you who saw this. Thank you.